The search engine Google is showing this interactive animated doodle in some countries on November 21st, 2022 to celebrate the life of Marie Tharp, an American geologist and oceanographic cartographer who helped prove the theories of continental drift. She co-published the first world map of the ocean floors. On this day in 1998, the Library of Congress named Tharp one of the greatest cartographers of the 20th century. Today's Google Doodle features an interactive exploration of Tharp's life. A story is narrated by Caitlin Latson, Rebecca Nessel, and Dr. Tiara Moore, three notable women who are currently living out Tharp's legacy by making strides in the traditionally male-dominated ocean science and geology spaces. Mary Tharp was an only child born on July 30, 1920 in Michigan. Tharp's father, who worked for the U.S. Department of Agriculture, gave her an early introduction to map making. She attended the University of Michigan for her master's degree in petroleum geology. This was particularly impressive given so few women worked in science during this period. She moved to New York City in 1948 and became the first woman to work at Lamon Geological Observatory, where she met geologist Bruce Hazen. Hazen gathered ocean depth data in the Atlantic Ocean, which Tharp used to create maps of the mysterious ocean floor. New findings from echo sonders, that is, sonars used to find water depth, helped her discover the mid-Atlantic ridge. She brought these findings to Hazen, who infamously dismissed this as girl talk. However, when they compared these V-shaped rips with earthquake epicenter maps, Hazen could not ignore the facts. Plate tectonics and continental drift were no longer just theories. The seafloor was undoubtedly spreading. In 1957, Tharp and Hazen co-published the first map of the ocean floor in the North Atlantic. 20 years later, National Geographic published the first world map of the entire ocean floor penned by Tharp and Hazen, titled The World Ocean Floor. Tharp donated her entire map collection to the Library of Congress in 1995. On the 100th anniversary celebration of its Geography and the Map Division, the Library of Congress named her one of the most important cartographers in the 20th century. In the year 2001, the same observatory where she started her career awarded her with its first annual Lament Doherty Heritage Award. Click on today's Google Doodle to begin your journey through Tharp's extraordinary life and scientific contributions.
Marie Tharp was a geologist and cartographer whose groundbreaking maps changed the way we view our planet. At the start of her career in the 1950s, much of the land on Earth had already been mapped, but the ocean remained a mystery. Scientists began to study it using the newly invented sonar. They pinged the ocean floor and used the bouncing sound waves to calculate depth. Click to ping the ocean floor. Good job! Now we can see the depths of the ocean floor. In those early days of Marie's research, boat captains were superstitious about having women on board. So Marie's mapping work depended entirely on reports from her colleague, Bruce Hazen, and the rest of the research team. Using Bruce's data, Marie drafted height profiles of the Atlantic Ocean floor.
She relied on her map background to interpolate areas where data were insufficient. Connect the dots to help Marie fill in the estimated floor height map. She filled in gaps in the data as she mapped and was able to get a clearer picture of the ocean floor. After analyzing the data, Marie realized that all of her height maps showed the same dip. There must be a rift running across the ocean floor. Bruce was skeptical. A rift indicated continental drift, an unpopular geologic theory at the time. So he erased Marie's work and instructed her to redo it. Marie went back to the drawing board. Connect the dots to help Marie fill in the estimated floor height map. She filled in gaps in the data as she mapped and was able to get a clearer picture of the ocean floor. The second set of data still showed the rift. Her colleague, Howard Foster, had been mapping earthquake activity in the same area. So they decided to overlay their maps. Swipe to overlay the maps. The patterns matched. Even Bruce was convinced. The rift existed, and so did continental drift.
Marie and Bruce began publishing papers and giving talks about their discovery, but the scientific community remained unconvinced. For proof, skeptical scientists turned to the newly invented underwater camera. They were going to uncover the truth about the ocean floor once and for all. Does Marie's rift really exist? Use the arrows to help find photographic proof. The rift really did exist. Video evidence undeniably showed the existence of the Mid-Atlantic Ridge and its rift valley. The critics had proven themselves wrong, and the scientific community finally believed in Marie and Bruce's findings. Marie continued this work for the rest of her life. Her intricate maps fueled a paradigm shift in our fundamental understanding of our own planet's history. Marie's work paved the way for research on plate tectonics that still continues today, shedding light on how the Earth moves and changes over time.